Hey guys, Hackersploit here, back again with another video, and in this video we're going to be looking at fuzzing with .pwn. Now, before we actually get started with the video, I want to wish everyone a happy new year. I know this video is being released on New Year's Eve, but a huge happy new year to everyone on the channel, to all my old subscribers and to my new subscribers. We have a huge year ahead of us, and as I mentioned, there have been a lot of changes I've been making to the channel over the last few months, just really improving my situation so that I can be uploading a whole lot more videos. And as I mentioned, you should be expecting about 1 to 3 videos daily without fail. So that's really what I want to focus on now. That being said, I wish you a very happy new year, and let's get started. So, as I mentioned in today's video, we are going to be looking at fuzzing with .pwn. Now, for those of you who do not know what .pwn is, it is essentially a directory traversal fuzzer that allows you to identify directory traversal vulnerabilities on various services. Now, these services range from web servers, so HTTP, HTTP URLs, FTP, and the TFTP protocols. All right, so a lot of people asked me or were suggesting this to me. And by the way, you can leave your video suggestions on the website or on my Discord server. Don't worry, all the links will be in the description section. So a lot of people were requesting for fuzzing, more specifically web application fuzzing. So first off, let me start by explaining what fuzzing is. All right, so this is a standard definition given on Wikipedia. So I quote from this definition. So fuzz testing or fuzzing is essentially quality assurance technique used to discover coding errors and security loopholes in software, operating systems, or networks. So essentially what it does, it involves inputting massive amounts of random data that is called fuzz to test that the crash or to give out unexpected responses. So essentially you're inputting a huge amount of data into the service, whether it be a web server, FTP protocol, etc. And you're essentially trying to get it to crash or to give out unexpected responses. That's what fuzzing is. Now, as I mentioned, .pwn is essentially a directory traversal fuzzer. So you might be wondering, well, what is a directory traversal vulnerability? It's something that I've talked about very briefly in CTF videos. If you remember some of the VulnHub videos, there is one specifically where I talked about it, and we were able to exploit the directory traversal vulnerability. So a directory traversal or path traversal, as it's called, essentially consists of exploiting insufficient security validation or sanitization of user applied input file names. All right, so the goal of this attack is essentially to use an affected application to gain unauthorized access to the file system. So essentially you're trying to gain access to files on the file system using the vulnerability. Now, of course, as I mentioned, this is very popular on the FTP protocols and the web servers, where you can essentially get directories like the etc password directory, etc., etc. Now, the tool .pwn comes pre-installed with Kali and is extremely popular for automating the fuzzing process for directory traversal. Now, many web application penetration testers will vouch for this, and it's for some reason, this is a tool that's kept in the dark or kept secret for some reason, because as I mentioned, it's extremely popular because it automates the entire fuzzing process for directory traversal. Now, we will also be taking a look at, in the next set of videos, we'll be taking a look at the WFuzz, which is also web application fuzzer. And do not worry for those of you concerned about the exploit development series, that is still ongoing. As I mentioned, we need to also have a large variety on the channel. All right, so let's get started with .pwn. So as I mentioned, it comes pre-installed with Kali Linux and all the other penetration testing distributions as far as I'm concerned. So to essentially use it, you essentially type in .pwn, and we use the help menu right over here to essentially bring it up and to understand the options that we can specify. So it's an extremely simple tool, and again, you can go ahead and look at the information there or check out the website. So this is a directory traversal fuzzer, and the options to use it are very simple. You need to specify a module and the host, and you have an additional options here. So the module essentially sorts out the your target in terms of what service or protocol it's using. So you have HTTP, HTTP URL, FTP, TFTP, TFTP, yes, and the payload. So you can specify whatever service you're trying to essentially fuzz there for directory traversal. You then have the hostname, which is the IP or the target URL. You can then also use operating system detection, which essentially uses the nmap scripts right over here. And then you can specify the operating system type if known. So you can specify with the following options. So Windows, Unix, or generic. Now, we're not going to be looking at all of this, but you can again test this out for yourself. And we also have service version detection or banner grabbing, similar to what we have with the SV command in Nmap. Now, the most important options or settings that we're going to be looking at right over here is, of course, we're going to be taking a look at the module, the host name, the depth, which you can specify for yourself. I do recommend leaving this to the default. The depth of traversals essentially refers to the how deep you want your scan to go, or how deep you want your fuzz to go. By default, it is set to 6, which is excellent because that really is one that will give you what you're looking for. You can then look for specific file names. That's if you're testing for specific directory traversal vulnerabilities. So if you are looking for, operating system specific ones. So if you are using Windows, then if you're using a Windows target, or you're targeting a Windows service or a Windows server, then really looking for the etc password directory will not be of much use because it does not even have that directory. It is, you're essentially searching or fuzzing for a Linux file system. So that will not make sense. In this case, our target, the only one I could find, I have a WordPress one here, but that's not running. I have a Metasploitable 2 virtual machine right over here. All right, so the Metasploitable 2 is currently running, and I think the IP address is 192.168.1.110. And of course, the Metasploitable 2 runs a web server, so we'll be testing that right now. Now, a lot of people in the Vulnhub CTF video, I'm not sure which one it is, I will check up on it. When I did find the directory traversal vulnerability, I did not say how I found it, and I found it using .pwn, which says a lot about it. And again, I apologize if I didn't mention that, because as I mentioned, it's a tool that is really kept in the dark for some reason, but an extremely powerful tool. And I do recommend that you run this every time you're attacking a host or you're performing a CTF with a web server. It really is a fantastic tool. All right, so let me show you how one would go about using it. So let me just clear this up here, and we start off with providing the .pwn command right over here, and we select the module. In this case, we're specifying a web server, so the module is HTTP. The host is then where we specify the 192.168.1.110. If you are using a URL, you can specify the module appropriately right over here. You can also specify your directory traversal depth by using the D command here, but I'm not going to do that. I like leaving it at the default, which is 6, which pretty much gives me the results that I'm looking for. And also, if you want to specify the operating system, which is important, if you're targeting a Windows operating system, you can do that as well. So you want to hit enter, and it's going to give you your target information right over here, the protocol you're using and the port. And as you can see, the traversal engine starts right over here. So creating traversal patterns, which is a mix of dots and slashes, which most of the people do not understand. Please remind me to make a video explaining directory traversal. We then have multiplying 6 times the traversal patterns, which you can, of course, use. You can specify using the D switch, as I mentioned earlier. And you can it's then going to create the special traversal patterns, etc., etc. And the traversal engine is going to tell you that it's done right over here. And the total traversal test created is 11,028. And it is ready to essentially start the traversal. So it's going to tell you ready to launch 3.3 traversals per second, which is pretty good. And we want to hit enter to start, and it's going to start the directory traversal fuzzing right over here. And as you can see, it's going through all the paths that that are important, really, and into different depths. So you can see it starts all the way from 1 all the way to 6 in terms of the directory traversal depth on the amount of directories it goes through. Now, you can specify more if you want, and it's all about testing results to see what you get. Now, the data is sorted very simply. You have your HTTP status codes right over here, which I'll explain in a second. And you have the testing path, which again is something very interesting, because for those of you who have seen the Vulnhub video, you notice that I was able to get, access the etc password directory and a few others, which essentially allowed me to see the hashed passwords for all the users and to get other users on the system. So a very, very huge vulnerability if exploited. Now, of course, you have your HTTP status codes. Now, your HTTP status codes are very simple to understand if you have learned about HTTP or the web. When you're talking about the 400 status codes, 400 essentially stands for a bad request. You then have your 404, which is very simple. It means it's not found. So these are all telling us that none of these are actually being found, or this target is not vulnerable to any of these directory traversal vulnerabilities, until you get a 200 status code, which tells you, yes, we have found one, and then you can go ahead and explore it. So that is pretty much how to decipher the results that you're getting. All right. Now, of course, I'm not sure if Metasploitable 2 is vulnerable to directory traversal. Once we start performing other CTF challenges, we will be able to test. If we do find one, we will be using .pwn now a whole lot more now that I've explained how to use it. And of course, you can test this on any target or CTF that you're doing, and you'll be shocked at how many you are actually able to find. So that's going to be it for this video. Hopefully I will be able to explain this tool in more detail, but I've pretty much explained all that I needed to. So if you found value in this video, please leave a like down below. If you have any questions or suggestions, let me know in the comment section on my website or on my social networks, and I'll be sure to give you a reply there. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for the support, and I'll be seeing you in the next video. Peace.